for anyone who comes from people who were colonized and couldn't imagine what your ancestors endured, or if, you know, if these recent events on videos have been happening in Palestine forever, over 70 years, like, imagine literally what's been going on, and we haven't been able to see that.
Israel is a white nationalist, like, ethno-supremacist state, and you see the way that they treat Ethiopians and African refugees, and it becomes obvious that even if you're a Jew and you're black, you still are a second-class citizen there.
A video went viral of police violently beating an Israeli soldier of Ethiopian descent.
Minutes after the rally, 1,000 Israelis rioted, attacking African homes and businesses and assaulting any African they found in the street. Days later, Yulia Shmuelov-Belkovich, at the time a legislator from the centrist opposition party Kadima, called for Israelis who advocate for the Africans to be locked in prison camps alongside the asylum seekers.
Example, and I'm gonna leave you.
All right.
Israel, you think that Israel will, like, by the way, the whole thing about the Yemeni children, you can find it in the New York Times, it's called, like, the lost children of Israel, the forgotten. But even when Ethiopian people were immigrated to Israel, Ethiopian Jews, women then report, 2013, that's not like 50 years ago, they reported that they were given against their consent and without their knowledge contraceptive shots so they wouldn't reproduce because they are the wrong color.
Many of Israel's Ethiopian immigrants are poor and have little education. They arrived here as part of a program to fly all the remaining Jews out of Ethiopia. But some women say they were coerced into taking injections every 3 months for birth control.
At the meeting, they said, you don't need to give birth so many times. If you give birth a lot, you will suffer in life. You need a job in Israel. So we said, if that's true, we will never be able to get out of here. So we took the shot.
Boy,
Floyd Mayweather. What he has done for Israel and the Jewish community is just so incredible, and to have someone like him speak out for us.
I'm behind you guys 100%. God bless you, Floyd.
So this just shows you all celebrities are controlled. You don't see no celebrities talking about the Balenciaga situation.
We don't have no power. No matter what we do, we can all click up. We don't have no organization that holds any weight. NAACP don't hold no weight. We don't have no organization that holds no weight.
American Jews played a key role in the founding and funding of some of the most important civil rights organizations. Just after Cheney, Goodman, and Schwerner disappeared, 17 rabbis were arrested alongside Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King.
The white man pays Reverend Martin Luther King, subsidizes Reverend Martin Luther King, so that Reverend Martin Luther King can continue to teach the Negroes to be defenseless. That's what you mean by nonviolent. Be defenseless. Be defenseless in the face of one of the most cruel beasts that has ever taken the people into captivity.
You can't speak bad about a Jewish person because they have organizations and they're a close-knit group of people in power who will bring you down. Same thing with gays. You can't say nothing bad about gays because they move as a unit. Black people don't have that.
Drake is the most famous Jewish person on earth. Khaled is the most famous Palestinian in the world. But neither one of them has said anything about this at all. Mm-hmm. And people are saying, well, they're not politicians, whatever. They influence hundreds of millions of people, which ultimately has an influence on the world. And you're not choosing to say anything. And Drake, who has a Jewish mother, you know, which by Jewish law makes him Jewish. But not only that, his parents got divorced when he was 5 years old, and he grew up with his Jewish mother and her Jewish relatives in Forest Hills, which is a Jewish community in Toronto. He had a bar mitzvah. And then when this happens, he doesn't say anything because I think that he doesn't want to potentially affect his record sales.
Well, why does he have to say anything? Why does him or Khaled have to say anything publicly?
They don't have to say anything. Mm-hmm. But I'm saying as representatives of these communities, their voices are powerful and they should say something.
I love Jewish people, but they're powerful. I don't want them to misconstrue anything I'm saying or take anything I'm saying the wrong way. So I would much rather not even have this conversation. I have a lot of great Jewish people in my corner. I have a Jewish conglomerate.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
You either win with us or you watch us win. Everyone has a choice. The choice is yours. Ivan, get me coming out the car and everything. Get the sneakers. Get the sneakers. That's what it's about. Family, fun, good energy. They ain't believing us. God did.
Gambling is used extensively all over the world to launder money. If I was to estimate based on the amount of accounts I've seen of that nature, it would have to be millions and millions of dollars that are laundered every year.
Most people can't relate to online gambling, but we've been socially conditioned to accept Drake as part of pop culture. He even said that he's going to give back to the people. This world is diseased. Stake.com's commercials are designed to appeal to the peripheral processing route. They are literally telling you that you're too stupid and lack the cognitive ability to read deeper.
Being from Canada. Imagine saying I'm a man. From where? From Canada. What? That doesn't go together. What are you talking about? Wait, you're a man? From Canada? Nah. Can't be. No, I'm a man. Nah, you're not rough. Of course you're not. There's no men in Canada. Fucking joke.
Drake shows off his painted nails. Thoughts, this is the reason I deny meeting all the famous people who tried to meet me.
What? 1,000 women have said to me, Drake has the hands of a girl.
Look at that! Baby hands! You let those hands touch you?
Those are soft, baby hands!
You know why there's not a lot of Jewish rappers? Because there's Jewish owners and Jewish CEOs. They run these labels. They're the bosses. That's why.
Hello, I'm going to go to the house.
אז אוטומטי עדיין הם עוד לא משרתים אותנו לגמרי, רק חלקית.
כל אחד יהיה לו, כשמשיח יבוא, אז כל אחד יהיה לו...
יהיה לו
אלפים עבדים. 2,800
עבדים. בינתיים, המשיח לא כאן, אז איך הם משרתים אותנו?
הם בונים לנו רכבים,
דירות,
בניינים.
הם עושים הכל.
הם בונים את זה, לנו. משרתים את היהודים.
Look at all these false idols. They're just Satan worshippers corrupting the youth. I mean, isn't it clear when you look at their videos? To this day, I still can't understand why people are waiting in line to revere someone that will drag them into such a low vibrational state. And if you're a parent, why would you even expose your kids to this garbage? And you know what's wild? You can always see the progression from when they started with cute little songs to win our hearts to eventually making devil music. And the big record labels are 100% on board with the agenda, so they'll tell them, you want to stay on top? Here's what you got to do, and here's your new outfit. Let's go, we got some people to dumb down here. And you know what's really insane? Corporations and luxury brands are sponsoring these clowns. It's shameful. Good music should always empower us, not destroy us.
It's dark and demonic energy that this industry was built on. And people manipulate young women, they manipulate kids.
Drake sitting here saying that, you know, his career is being guided by, you know, something else. No matter how good he writes or whatever, there's something else that's guiding his career.
Use all my heart and my soul, you know, in my writing. But at the end of the day, I am being guided by some other power. I don't know what it is.
And closed doors, a lot of six God worshiping. Yeah. We got London on the track. This is all God's doing, man, you can't plan it. But if the devil's in the details, then I'm satanic.
Devil's working overtime. Voodoo spells put on my life.
Then here you have this song, all right? He says that you're scared of the six, conveniently, three times. Now, some people say, well, he's talking about Canada, but he says the six three times. I don't think the area code of Canada is 666, and then why would we be scared of Canada? So listen to this.
Scared of the six. Yeah, you're scared of the six. Yeah, you're scared of the six. Yeah.
So, you know, there's a lot of demonic symbolism. You can see the imagery. You can see, you know, the owl and things like that. But I want to bring your attention to what happened recently at one of his concerts, right? They have, I don't know, they've got this infatuation with portals, right? And so check this out. So I want you guys to take a look at this Drake clip from a recent concert, all right? So you see he's sitting on this bed. He's a young version of himself. I guess it's like a hologram or something. They've been using a lot of those. And then you see the screen right here. It's changing. It's transitioning. It shows him when he was, you know, a TV actor. I guess like, you know, going through that timeline of his success. And then here's where it starts getting a little weird. So you see that the lights are changing. He's going to bed. The lights turn off. And then here comes this like shadowy spirit kind of thing. Now, some people were arguing, oh, this is just a reference to Peter Pan. But the guy who wrote Peter Pan, apparently, you know, he's like a Freemason and he practice witchcraft, sorcery, or he was into that kind of stuff. Either way, all right, you see this shadowy creature, right, moving around. You want to say it's a reference to Peter Pan, but watch this, right? Starts spinning, splits into a whole bunch of different, you know, versions of that shadow and begins to create a portal right here. I don't remember that in Peter Pan, right? Splitting into a bunch of shadows. And so it's spinning here, spinning, creating this portal, and then eventually here comes Drake. He's going to come out of that portal. So is that like some kind of symbolism for like, okay, you know, Satan visited me, you know, he talks about being the sixth god and all that kind of stuff, and we'll dive into some other stuff, but here he comes out the portal, right? And is this like symbolic of, oh man, this was my transition when I had this encounter, all right? Why is it that they're just so infatuated, you know, with this stuff in the music industry? We talk about it all of the time. And look, you got this, what's this goofy guy, Ja Rule? I mean, first of all, it's terribly corny and hard. What is he in his boxers? Like, what's going on? Like, this is just the facial expressions. It looked like Master Splinter. Like, what are you doing? I don't know. It's just, but what is their infatuation? Like, you never see them do this with, you know, Muslims or any other religion. They always take some kind of element of Christianity and they want to mock it. Lastly, this is some artwork from his son. And he changed it. He's got some kind of thing, I guess, with the red eyes, you know, demon time, demon eyes, whatever it is. But you see the original drawing, and then he decided to take it and change it to make it look more demonic. So, I mean, there's an infatuation there. It's not just entertainment. This isn't just, you know, some kind of, you know, like, they're going out of their way to do this. And you see it over and over again in the music industry. So either you're going to just make excuses and you're going to keep listening to the stuff and opening yourself to these demonic portals and these spirits, because there are, you know, spirits influencing these people. We've talked about it all the time. The Bible says that, you know, if they didn't love the truth, you know, there's going to be a strong delusion that the God of this world has blinded them. People who don't love the truth, that try to ignore the truth, that try to reject the truth, right? You're setting yourself up to be deceived because you want your idols.
Hey guys, if you want to watch more clips, click here.
And if you want to watch the full podcast, click right here.